Okay, welcome y'all back to Phandalin. This is session 7. I'll go ahead and give y'all a little bit of recap from session 5 because it's been a little bit. In session 5, Isadora had bartered with the apothecary Revelant Rodros. Echo wrote to Great Balataria's Order of the Crimson Rite, reporting that they were unable to capture the Oracle. And you had sent detailed sketches and an account of what was experienced. Afterward, you had joined Isadora and also bartered with the apothecary. And in exchange for potion components at a discount, the two of you had promised to investigate Revelin Rodros' cousin, Dierna Dazlin. Oh, I guess her name's Dazlin. Dierna Dazlin's expedition. Lance was led beneath Tresdane Manor, where the Red Brands have fortified a building. Ships, you found after speaking with an individual there that ships have been attacked to the west. An unusual storm has gathered above Shipwreck Isle. There is an exceedingly dangerous job. They are interested in taking it on. It's an opportunity. If you succeed, you will be considered part of the Red Brands. And you are to accompany a small mercenary group. There will be no pay until the job is completed. But like I said, completion means entry into the Red Prince. Isadora visited a tanner to commission a wolf pelt cape. Noticing the tanner was deaf, she resolved to design a hearing aid for him. She also visited the town clinic, flexed her ability to create potions, and met the woman running the clinic named Raffaella. You had questioned the bartender about the Red Brands, and she had told you that they showed up and have just sort of sitting in place in town, almost as soon as the trouble all sort of began. In addition, Harbin Wester told you that the mountains are freezing over in the east. There are cult attacks up in Thunder Tree to the northwest. The town's been busy rebuilding the wall, other oddities. And before you all left town, you made a stop at Isadora's hut. And from there, you left, did a bunch of RP last session, and encountered a wandering hill giant, which Isadora introduced herself to, prompting the massive creature to lurch for her, attempting to eat her. Afterward,
oh, that's right.
She walked
right up to it.
That's right. However, you all managed to fell the titanic creature and found yourselves surrounded by a group of ram-like centaurs who... They sort of like appeared in acknowledgement, and they all sort of like, you know, gave you a nod like that was pretty damn impressive, and then they all sort of like just disappeared again into the woods. So that brings you all to here. You have camped out overnight. Is there anything else you're wanting to do here?
We'll just say Echo did some sketches of those centaur people that they saw.
Okay. Go ahead and roll me a sleight of hand check.
Oh, okay. Sleight. 13.
Okay. Not too bad. You've been able to get something pretty solidly down. You're pretty quick with the sketching from what we've seen so far. All right, Lance, anything you'd like to be doing this morning?
Did I successfully go hunting, or was I interrupted by...
Ooh, I remember you wanted to.
Yeah, but I ran into a centaur that didn't like the fact I was hunting. And then... I got interrupted by, like, the sound of the giant. And then ran back to camp.
Gotcha. Okay.
Is there any place that I could probably hunt that's close by that isn't so patrolled by the centaur?
I would say that you don't know.
I'd like to hunt at least close to the camp and just look for small game, if not bigger.
Okay, go ahead and roll me a survival check.
Alright, survival. Looks like I'm gonna starve.
Well, that's okay, Lance. Despite your poor luck, you do still have, I believe, several days of rations.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. I don't wanna eat shitty rations. I want meat. It's God damn it.
Rations again.
Ugh, gross. Veggie omelet.
Okay, okay. So, that concluded. The group of you are going to make your way to where the excavation was. Oh, you know what? Actually, let me do something real quick. Oh,
yes.
My goodness.
Oh, my Trying God. To find Dierna.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready to travel when you are.
Yeah, I'm ready. Oh, here we go.
Okay. All right. So. Can everybody see?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. This
is okay. Okay, excellent. Mm. Let me actually reset.
I don't know if it's me lagging or the map. Let me reload.
It may be the map.
Yeah, it's a big map.
There's dynamic lighting on this map.
Oh.
It might be heavy.
That's fine, it's not like unplayable. My token just lags a little when I drag it.
Okay. So, following the path that Dierna left with her cousin Revelin, and, what's his brother's name? Revelin and Arden, I believe. Arden Rogers. You have, appeared at this narrow crevice along these mountains. And there's, along, the stone ways, this very intentionally constructed wall that looks very old, and it stands here. And you can see the expeditions to, turn that down just a hair. The expeditions to wagons that they use to carry much of their supplies here.
Do I see anybody, anything down the ways, like towards, like through the gap?
Nope. It's perfectly quiet.
Okay, I'm gonna roll stealth.
Like whistling through.
I'm gonna roll stealth and sneak along, searching each of these wagons.
Okay.
We'll also roll stealth.
Go ahead and roll it up.
And I really need to make a stealth, but.
Oh, yeah.
Too much.
22.
Yeah, self-perception and investigation are must-haves.
11.
11? Okay, and a 22?
Mm-hmm.
Isidore will do the same. Okay, so what would y'all like to do as you're creeping along?
There's the carriages. Why not see like what they have in them mainly. I'm not really looking for anything in particular.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just trying to see anything out of the ordinary or what would be typical.
Echo will go to the opposite one of Lance so they can do both at the same time.
Okay, sure. So just show me which one y'all go to just so I can
take the right one.
Oh, well.
Okay, I'll move Lance
over
here.
Oh, okay. Well, just look, I'll take this one.
Okay. I'm okay. Sure thing. I'm zoomed in on the map right now, is what it is. Okay, so Lance is checking out the back. Echo, you're checking this one here. Now, Lance, as you are making your way around to this wagon here, you kind of like peer over at these tents, and both are just perfectly still and silent, even as your footsteps kind of like, you know, not loudly, but sort of quietly, like crunch through. You can hear your footsteps louder than anything else. And as you and Echo both climb into these wagons here, and Isidore will accompany you, Echo, you can see all of these crates have been opened. The chest has been opened. The barrels are empty. Several of them are busted, broken open.
Is there any remnants inside, like, that I can tell what used to be in the barrels?
Sure. So, looking in the barrels, so like this one here next to you, Lance, as you peer inside, you can see that there are several grains of what appear to be like rice and like barley, something that they would eat maybe over long travels.
So they were raided.
And Isidora, Echo over there, you see like clothes and you also see like food and such, or what would have been, but is scant and empty.
Gotcha. Echo's just gonna look over at Lance, make eye contact, shake their head, no, and then keep moving forward towards this area stealthily.
I'm gonna look like, through the tents. There's nothing here, you know. See if they have if it's the same with the tents.
Where are these tents? I'm not seeing these tents.
They're right here.
All right, so Lance, climbing down. You step around and you look into the tents. And looking about the inside of the tents, there is no blood. There's nothing left within the tents, save for fabric. The simple canvas that the tents are made of.
And there's no bedrolls or anything, just fabric?
I would say yes, there is a bedroll.
Okay. So no belongings whatsoever, just basic fabric.
I would say there's a pile of clothes.
Okay.
There are clothes that have been like kind of messily tossed in the corner. They're still sitting there.
I'm gonna inspect the clothes to check and see if there's blood or anything in them.
The clothes are a little stiff with what appear to be dried sweat. There is no blood on them.
Okay. Alright, so I regroup with Echo and I say, keep your eyes peeled on the cliffs and let's push through.
Alright. Let's do this quietly now.
Let me know when I can reroll stealth.
Okay.
And I think I'm not going to go past this wall, but I'm going to go up to it and try and kind of peer around it.
Okay.
Stealthily.
Isidore will be sneaking alongside the two of you.
Okay.
Sorry, what were you saying?
I was going to prepare an action for an attack, just in case.
Sure, what would you like to do?
Just have my crossbow ready.
Okay. With a healthy paranoia, you all proceed. And you're just peeking around the corner?
Yeah.
Okay. Echo. Peeking around the corner, you see ruined structures. They appear to be like old stone constructed buildings. Rather primitive in design, but certainly aged and crumbling. From here, you can see there are tents inside several of these structures, which only have, like, partial roofing. It appears the expedition may have been using these structures to set up camp in.
Okay. Do I see anyone moving about? Is it quiet?
Dead silent.
I'll turn to Lance and say, I do not see or hear anyone. I think it is safe to look around.
All right, just be on your guard.
Right. I pull out my hand knife. My knife. Dagger.
Okay.
And we keep going.
Okay. So you all wander in.
I'm like looking at like the walls and ground as I'm walking through these like ruins.
Make me an insight check. Actually, I'm just gonna tell you, there's something unusual here, Lance, that gives you a bit of a funny feeling, but you can't quite put your feeling your finger on what it is.
The fact that there's no people.
You can't quite put your finger on what it is.
Ooh.
You've noticed something on some level that strikes you as odd, but you can't quite say what it is. Just a hunch that you have. So as you enter, there's nothing but this, the wind as it kind of whistles through this slice in the mountains, and stepping inside this structure, Lance, you see this extinguished campfire here, and these two tents, and I would say that there would also be, to some degree, a few knickknacks, like some minor toiletries and such, that appear to have been sort of discarded about randomly. Echo, you will see this as well.
Okay. Inspect the tent, I think.
Okay. Echo, looking inside the tent, there is nothing in the tent. It's just empty, but canvas. There's not even a bedroll.
Okay. I think I have an idea. Sorry, I'm looking through my... Okay. I'm gonna turn to Lance and just say, so we're looking for Dirna, correct? So we need to find her wherever she is.
I guess we just go further in.
Alright. I'm going to cast Heartbeat and lead the way. And have it going, sensing for any heartbeats around me as we go, within 30 feet of me.
Okay, let me think for a second.
Okay, you got it.
Give me like 5 seconds to be sad.
Oh!
Okay.
Where are you? Oh, you're right there.
You're going to sense a lot of heartbeats. A lot of heartbeats.
Where?
They are... see, it's 30 feet. Okay. You're going to sense... Let me check something real quick. There are several here beneath you. Like inches from Lance's feet.
I'm going to look at him and I say, don't move!
And you can feel about 6 heartbeats.
Don't move.
It's like, what do you see?
Don't see it. I hear it. What is it?
It's here. So you can feel 6 heartbeats underground along here.
I'm gonna point with my finger along that line to just point, and I'm gonna say, I hear 6 heartbeats underground. I don't know what it is, but there are 6 of them.
I like gestured like to back up and let's just like back out of here.
But we need to find Dierna.
Something's not right.
I know it. I can hear them. I'm gonna take just like 10 feet this direction. Do I hear any others? Just to expand that range.
Yeah, I would say you feel one more right over here.
Underground as well?
It's not underground. You can like see the corner of the rubble, and you can't see it, but you can feel it on the other side of the rubble. Like just out of sight.
I'm going.
Oh, I was just gonna say behind the wall.
Okay. I'm gonna point in that direction silently and look at Lance.
Get my bow ready and inch toward it.
I guess stealth.
Okay.
Gotta find Dierna.
Roll me a stealth check.
27.
27. Holy shit. Okay.
Oh shit, my leg's cramping. I gotta let Echo go first.
So Echo, as you come around this corner... Damn it.
And this way?
There we go. Yeah, as you come around this corner...
I'm sorry, am I going this way?
Oh, I don't know. Whichever way you go, are you headed down that way?
Sure. I thought you meant this corner right here.
Oh, no. Sorry. I meant this corner.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. I'm there. As I come around this corner.
Gotcha. As you come around this corner, you do not see this thing. But you can now tell that it is underground and it's like beneath this wall somehow. But looking at it, looking at the wall, at the terrain, you don't see anything that, like, looks disturbed about it.
Okay.
Actually, roll me an investigation.
Yeah. 22.
Ooh, that's pretty fucking good. All right, Echo. So here's what happens.
Oh, boy.
You open up, you're like sort of peering at this stone, and you see grass, or just like the smallest hint of grass that's sort of like tucked into stone, as if something closed over it.
Are you saying grass like green or brass like metalish?
Grass like green.
Okay.
And
okay.
It's like, imagine like it's been like a door has been closed on it. That's that's what I'm trying to like depict, as like something has been closed over it. And it's like bending into a stone, so to speak.
Is that where the heartbeat's coming from?
Yes, and you can just feel the heartbeat whirring excitedly inside.
Well, it hasn't messed with us, so I don't really want to mess with it. I think I'm just knowing what it kind of looks like. I'm going to slowly back away. And I think I'm going to come around the corner and then whisper to Lance.
There are certainly beings everywhere around here, but we need to find Dierna. What do you think we should do?
I think we figure out what these are first before we go deeper into this.
Well, I do see one right over there. I spotted it. Would you like me to, I guess, pull it out?
Let me take a look first. I'm going to go over to where they were pointing.
I will point at it directly so he can see what I'm looking at.
All right, make me an investigation check with advantage. She's pointing
you got this.
Right at it. It has to lower the DC something, I imagine. If not, just advantage.
Wait, 2d20.
Lance left his bifocals at home. All right. Is it adding those together?
Well, yeah, but you can see the two dice rolls and just add three to the highest.
Yeah, I'm tripping. It's supposed to do that. Okay, cool. So, with a 14, she's showing you exactly where it is. I will say that, yes, she shows you the grass, and you can certainly see it, although you cannot see in the rock, Lance, how this rock is supposed to open.
I try pulling on it.
As you're reaching for it, Lance, there is like a stone that just sort of like, and it just kind of like falls from up this cliff up here.
Mm-hmm.
Just like a harmless single like stone. It just happens to like drop from the cliff face.
I look up to see what pushed it.
Make me a perception check.
If I heard this, can I also make a perception check?
Yep.
Oh my god, why is my rolling so bad? Alright.
18.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay. So here's what we see. At this point, Ray, as Echo is looking up, and Lance, you're looking up, you're going to hear this sort of whirring, this chirping sound, as these creatures, and they're wearing these cloaks that sort of almost kind of make them look like the cliff face they're camouflaged in. They are going to turn over and kind of reveal themselves.
Ooh.
Kobolds.
Kobolds. Oh boy.
And at this chirping, whirring sound,
Lance has killed these before.
They are going to come flooding out of here. Now, Lance, I am going to say... Sorry. They're not there. They're kind of coming out of, like, one of these buildings here.
Oh my gosh.
I'll echo and say, we have to take cover immediately.
Take cover like hide or get to upper ground?
Don't get hit, that's all. These carry poison.
Got it. Lance, I will will say, these kobolds, you know kobolds to be like terrors among mercenaries. They employ ruthless tactics. They are very clever. They make use of traps, items, terrain, every trick in the book. So, with that being said...
Where there's kobolds, there's dragons.
Alright, can I have all of you roll me initiative?
Yes.
Oh my god, even my initiative is bad.
Oh shit. Right. He'll get there, man. He'll get there. It'll flip before the end of the session.
Oh, shit. It'll flip and I'm dead.
And Echo, what'd you get?
You got a 21.
Okay. All right, y'all. So as all of these kobolds reveal their positions along the cliff face. Let me see. I will give y'all half a turn, an action, and 15 feet of movement to decide how you want to handle this ambush.
I'm looking at sides. Are they on the walls and above us and stuff?
Yes, they're on the walls. They're on the cliff walls. They're like kind of crouching behind like corners and such.
Give us an action and 15 feet of movement. What can I do?
Is there any buildings that have like like a cover, like a roof over it, or no?
Yes. Okay, so I'm gonna remind you guys, actually this is actually on this map. Larger. So, don't forget that half cover is plus 2 AC, 3/4 cover is plus 5 AC, because you will need it.
Okay. Alright, so which direction is the building
actually,
with the roof
actually,
over
I'll tell
it?
You what, you all have one turn to go.
Alright, we're gonna take cover. Or I'm gonna take cover. Shit.
Alright, so where would you like to take cover?
Oh wait. Rest.
I'm trying to look at this map here.
Okay, so at this point too, we should go ahead and bring the other players in.
Okay. Totally.
In fact, let me just go ahead and get rid of some of these dynamic lighting lines.
Oh, Hunter, Daniel says hi. I don't know if you remember him.
Yeah, I remember Daniel. Yeah.
I like play Genshin Impact with him.
Really?
Yeah, I honestly never thought I would be playing that game, but it's actually kind of fun.
Hey man, if it's fun, it's the only thing that matters. Okay.